Shower thoughts. We've all had them at some point before. Not necessarily in the shower, but just those weird thoughts that don't really make that much sense at first. But then, the more that you think about them, the more you realize, well, they're kind of true, and sometimes they're sort of disturbing. So I went searching for some of the Cuban-related ones, and where did I go? I went to none other than Cuban subreddits, which is the absolute comedy gold of the Cuban community. And what I found certainly did not disappoint me, to say the least. So now I present to you 14 of the best shower thoughts, Cuban edition. There is a method to solve the 3x3 that is way more efficient than any other method ever created. The only problem is that you would have to learn 43 quintillion, 252 quadrillion, 3 trillion, 274 billion, 489,856,000 algorithms. Which, relatively speaking, if you've learned full OLL, how bad can this be, right? Any of us could get a world record at any time. It's just that you would have to be really, 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 really lucky. Is it theoretically possible that a robot could turn a Rubik's Cube so fast that it will spontaneously combust and start on fire? I mean, imagine the cube was spinning so fast, even if it's properly lubed, that there was so much friction that it heated up and literally started on fire. I mean, that would be crazy. It's well known that it's possible to one-look a 2x2. Those are the EG1 and EG2 methods. But did you know it's also possible to one-look a 3x3? It's just that usually people happen to wear a blindfold when they do it. A guy that can't cube is just a guy that can cube, but can't cube. See, this is the kind of crap that you're sort of signing up for by visiting r/cubers. It's literally just like saying, I can solve the cube in under a second, except I can't really solve the cube in under a second. See, Reddit is just a weird place. What have I done? We have all heard of keychain cubes, but have you really ever put a keychain cube on a keychain? The learning curve for cubing is actually really weird. At first, it takes you 5 minutes, and then after a bit of practice, you can get that down to a minute. And before you know it, 30 seconds and sub 20, and then for the best of us, sub 15 and even sub 10. But to go from 5 minutes to 1 minute took you like, what, 2 weeks? Well, on the other hand, going from sub 15 to sub 10 takes like 6 months, and I mean, heck, I'm not even sub 15 yet. In the history of the Rubik's Cube era, how many people have actually been smart enough to be able to just pick up a scrambled cube and solve it without any given tutorial or some method? I mean, imagine the first time that you picked up a scrambled cube and you could just solve it. No CFOP, no nothing. I mean, there's gotta be somebody that's done it. I mean, otherwise, how would we have gotten where we are right now, right? Why is it that some PLLs are so rare? I mean, how often do you really see a Z perm or an H perm? Well, you see like A perms and J perms like pretty much every other PLL. In the last 5 to 6 years, cubing hardware has improved so much and so fast that companies are actually sort of struggling to come up with new technology that actually makes a difference in people's times. On a similar note, cubes are actually a lot like iPhones. In the last 8 to 9 years, iPhones have transformed tenfold in their technology, and in pretty much the same time frame, cubes have too. We've all heard of God's number for a 3x3 Rubik's Cube, it's 20 moves. But the probability of the most efficient solution for a given scramble actually being 20 moves is very low. In fact, it's much, much more probable to have a 16, 17, or 18 move solution. Have we solved every scramble? I mean, there is a lot of scrambles, but there is also a lot of cubers. Alright, that's all of the Cuban shower thoughts that I've compiled for this video. If you guys want to see a part 2, definitely comment down below some of your Cuban shower thoughts, and we will definitely work them into a part 2. So other than that, hopefully you guys have an awesome day, and I will see you all next time. See ya!